It's Tuesday. It's Tuesday the 26th of December. It's Boxing Day. What did you do for Christmas? I came to Rochester Airport and I'm about to go into the Network Rail helicopter. Obviously. Gareth, the pilot. Do you just fly helicopters or do you fly planes as well?
No, just helicopters, yeah.
Is that skill not transferable?
It is, yes, but there are obviously a lot of differences, so you've got to be careful.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's got the Network Rail logo on the side, that's how you know.
Sean's got the sit bags if you need them.
I was worried about legroom. There's a surprisingly good amount of legroom. And this, by the way, is Chris.
Hey, how are you doing?
Chris.
Hello.
Chris is the reason that I'm here.
Thank you very much.
And we'll be interviewing Chris later, but this is all Chris's fault.
It's all my fault.
This is not your first time in the job,
no,
is it?
No,
how many
not.
Times have you done this, Chris?
I don't know, three or four?
As you got it now, that's okay. Lovely.
It's not a mic, it's a Britney stick. Oh baby, I shouldn't have let you go.
It's a Britney stick.
Yeah.
You've heard that before, right?
Yes.
It's a Britney stick.
Yeah. Now I'm taking pictures for Network Rail. Sean's got he's got a gimbal mounted camera on the front of the helicopter, which he uses for surveying. It's got thermal imaging kit in it and a very high definition camera as well, which can record moving pictures or stills. So he's going to be doing that. He's going to be surveying all the tracks as we go along. He's also going to do some moving pictures. So we've got some video from the helicopter. And I'm going to be doing stills for Network Rail, because we do lots of press releases, etc., and we always need pictures of stuff, and that's my job. So the plan today, I believe, is that we're going up to London Bridge. We're checking the diversionary route into Waterloo, because Southeastern trains from tomorrow, the 27th, are going to be diverted into Waterloo International, the old international platform. So we're surveying the tracks down into there, because they're not used very often. Then we're going to circuit London Bridge, Charing Cross, Cannon Street, make sure they're all right, and check the other diversionary routes into the town.
Fractures and cracks are picked up by our test train. We've got several test trains that run around the whole country. They cover the whole country every month. They use ultrasonics. They basically ping very high frequency sound through the rail, and that's how they detect if there's cracks. What the heat sensitive camera does is it looks at the electrical equipment. If a cable has a problem, it will start to overheat and it will start to glow. You wouldn't see that with your normal eyesight, but you would with the camera on the helicopter. And it may well be that that cable itself is fine, and the reason it's glowing is that a piece of electrical equipment has failed half a mile up the line and all the current's having to go through one cable. And again, that gives us the ability to send somebody out. We've told them exactly where the problem is and they can go down and fix it before it goes wrong.
We've landed, but we have a 2-minute shutdown period. Something to do with the engines, equalising temperature. So we can't just bundle out straight away. So we've got to wait 2 minutes. I'm getting out the cockpit. I'm getting out. We've survived. I've lived. The chopper didn't crash. I've got to get my bag. Well piloted.
Well done.
You're welcome. Yeah, no problem.
How long are we in the air for?
An hour and 10.
Yeah. It seemed like 20 minutes.
Yes.
I don't know if you could hear me say it inside, so I'll say it now. But if you've ever, obviously, probably a lot of you have taken an international flight, and if you land at Heathrow or Gatwick, for a few seconds, as you come in to land or take off, you see London from just a few hundred feet close up. So imagine, then you go, oh, look, there's so-and-so, but it's over in a few seconds. So imagine that, but for an hour, just looking at all of London, sort of in miniature. That was amazing. So this was Gary, right?
Yes.
That would have been embarrassing if I'd have got the name wrong. Gary, you don't work for Network Rail, do you?
No, that's right.
You work for an independent company that just happens to fly the choppers?
Yeah, I work for BDG Helicopters that contracts to Network Rail.
But are you exclusive Network Rail, or yes. Do you fly for anyone that pays you?
No, this is an exclusive contract that we work for.
People are going to want to know, how do I get the job of being the helicopter pilot for Network Rail? So how did you get the job?
It's been a long, hard road. I started off originally flying helicopters privately in the background, so I was working full time.
Right.
And then eventually built enough hours and time to become an instructor.
Right.
And then from an instructor built up hours to become a commercial pilot. And from there, you know, accrued enough hours to be able to secure a job like this.
Second, there's a gentleman down here by the name of Sean, and he's the man that's actually, I was just going to turn the camera. This is the camera that is on the bottom of the helicopter. Could you tell us about this camera, Sean?
Okay, yeah, so this is a Star Sapphire 380 HD multi-sensor thermal imaging system. Multi-sensor because it is a thermal imaging system primarily, but it's also got a high definition video camera in it, and it's also got a low light camera in it. So our low light camera, you need about 2 street lights, and for us it would look like this now, today. So it's an alternative to having thermal imaging for night operations. So you have the low light camera there and the high definition camera there, and the little bit in the middle is the laser rangefinder. So what we can do, we can fire a laser onto the ground and it will lock this camera to that point on the ground, not to a point in the sky, but a point on the ground, and it gives us an exact position of where that is. And then we convert that from latitude and longitude, or northings and eastings, into railway speak, miles and chains, because we work in miles and chains because it's one of those things. It's a quirk of the railways, we still work in miles and chains. So if we find a fault, we'll fire the laser onto the fault, we'll record a short clip of video footage, we convert that into a still grab of the fault, and we send that still grab with the exact mileage of where that fault is. And what it enables us to do is it enables us to send engineers to places where there are faults rather than engineers walking for miles looking for faults.
How much do you love your job?
I love it. I mean, I know today is Boxing Day and most people are...
Happy Christmas, by the
way. Yeah, happy Christmas yourself. Most people are now at home. What's the time now? It's 1:30, so they've probably got into the arguments now, so it's really good.
We're at the cold turkey sandwich.
Yeah, the cold turkey sandwich, and I don't want to watch EastEnders again. So, rather than do that, I'm out working.
What's the most scenic part of Britain that you've seen from the air in terms of the railway?
Scotland. Yeah. And it's got to be the West Highland Line up through the Kyla Lockhouse.
You've been to Carew as well.
Carew, Rannoch Moor, all of those places.
You've
are just
flown over it in a helicopter.
Yeah, absolutely
taking
fantastic.
Taking aerial.
Aerial yeah. photographs of it, video, all around the Highlands of Scotland. The West Highland Line is probably the most picturesque piece of railway line we've got. I mean, a lot of people like Dawlish Warren and that, but yeah. You know, once you get to up there, up to Scotland.
Scotland's right side.
Yeah. Yeah.
Although I debated...
Now, more importantly, how many hot drinks have you had today?
I haven't had any at all.
How much breakfast have you had today?
I haven't had any at all.
Nothing. We're
here. Have you explained why the airport is closed?
Why?
I mean, there's literally one room at this airport that's open.
Which is just the ropey old toilet.
And it was a very nice warm toilet.
We
nice
need to find a cafe. It's really badly.
There's a hotel. There's a hotel over there.
Should we go to the Holiday Inn and just see if they all serve us?
I think they will serve us.
Or if not, we need a greasy spoon that does an all day breakfast. But mainly, I've been for a ride in the Network Rail helicopter.
Yes!
Thanks very much.
Enjoy. It's been a real pleasure, Geoff. Thank you for coming to this freezing cold airfield on Boxing Day.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
What's that? Was that your, are you buying the tea? Are you
yes,
buying the tea?
That's exactly what I say. Are they doing Christmas dinner?
I've had my coffee. Not a prep, I'm Starbucks. That's Chris. Say thanks, Chris.
Cheers.
Well, that doesn't make sense. Cheers, Gary. You look different. We're not in your flight overalls. Cheers, Sean.
Cheers, Geoff.
Thanks, Holiday Inn. Thanks, Holiday Inn Rochester.
Thanks for coming, Geoff. Thanks
for
coming. Boxing Day.
On Boxing Day. Merry Christmas.
All the way to the Holiday Inn in Rochester.
Will you have me again?
Yeah.
I'll do it again. Okay, bye. Bye. Left-handed check. Left-handed.